In this video, we would look at a method for changing variable that contain age-related information. In the same data of mental health survey that we downloaded from Kaggle, there is a column for age. It gives the absolute age of the survey taker. Most of the time, when we are analyzing age-related data, we need to bundle up people together based on their age group. So, for instance, all the people in the age range between 20 to 30 would have their age mentioned as 20 to 30. This way, we can make a broad statement about people in this age group. It is very easy to convert absolute age figures into range of ages using the cut function. But before doing that, we need to examine the variable for any kind of issues. First, we will look at the result of the string function. It returns numeric and everything seems fine. After this, we are using the range function to know the range of numbers in this variable from smallest to largest. This time, the results are coming in exponential form because of the wide difference between the minimum and maximum values in the age column. R has chosen what it believes is the best way to present this information, which can be a bit confusing. Also, if we see the output of the summary function, the result is again coming in exponential form. Based on the output of range and summary function, we can be sure that there is definitely some wrong figures in this variable, which is making R give the results in this form. Before we correct the variable, we'll make the results more user-friendly. For this, we will use the options function and the shipen argument. This argument decides how the numeric values are printed. The default value for this argument is 0, which means R would decide the most suitable way to present the numeric data to us. We can bypass the default output by setting the shipen argument to 99. This would ensure that R returns the exact information the way it is presented inside the data. Now the information has become more intuitive and the output of the range function suggests the range in this column varies from -1726 to this number. These are not possible figures for age variable. The output from the summary function like mean, minimum and maximum also imply that we need to correct the data before we make any changes to the variable. Another way to get an idea of the abnormal values in the column is through the use of boxplot.stats function. One of the components in this function, out, would return the outliers in this column. The way the function finds outliers is through the use of these two formulas. So, any value that is below the value calculated using this formula would be classified as an outlier. Similarly, any value that is above the value calculated using this formula would also be classified as outlier. I am not explaining quantile 1 and quantile 3 as we have already gone through them in a previous video. Interquantile range is the difference between quantile 3 and quantile 1. Another way to quickly check the numeric column is by using the histogram function. This plot also suggests that there are incorrect values in the data. Since a column containing age should only have values between 15 and 99, we would get rid of all the values that are not in this range. It can be easily done using these two lines of codes. Now, if we execute the summary function on the age column, the results are looking more normal. One more issue that is bothering me in this column is the presence of survey takers that are below the age of 20. It is less likely that people in the 15 to 20 age group participated in the survey. Let us examine this group. Since we have removed all the ages below 15, let us see how many survey takers are still left that have ages below 20. Using the end row function, we can see that there are 24 rows where the ages of survey taker is below 20. The same thing can also be done using the length function by writing this code. To know the names of rows that have ages less than 20, we can use the which function. I am not removing these 24 rows. I just wanted to show the process of examining the data. Now that we have modified the data to our satisfaction, we can get back to the original goal of transforming the absolute age to range of ages. First, the way we want the ranges to be displayed should be saved in an R object. Here, I have created a vector of values and saved them inside an R object breaks. According to summary function, the minimum value in the age column is 18 and the maximum value is 72. So the values inside the breaks are between 18 and 75. I want each range to roughly cover 5 years. So everyone having the ages between 25 and 29 should be included in the 25 to 30 range. This range would of course also include people with ages of 25 and 29. Similarly, survey takers with ages between 30 and 34 should be included in the 30 to 35 range. The way to do that is through the cut function. First argument for this function is the variable that we need to convert into range. Second argument is breaks that needs a vector of values which would act as the reference point for combining the age data. We have already created a vector with the same name breaks. We would supply that vector to the second argument. The third argument in this function is write. I have set this argument to false because I don't want the values on the right of any age range to be included in that particular range. For example, a survey taker with an age of 30 would not be included in the range 25 to 30. Instead, that person would be covered in the range of 30 to 35. Similarly, a survey taker with an age of 35 would be included in the 35 to 40 range and not in the 30 to 35 range. The new variable that we created inside the data is age category. If we go through the output of string function for this column, it is saved as factor. You can further check this new variable using the summary function. Now, as you can see, we have a much more precise idea about the ages of survey takers. We will stop this video here. From the next video onwards, we will begin exploring the different ways we can fill in the empty cells in the data.